mixed doubles final, Singapore Smash 2024. First point on the board for the Chinese.
It's a solid receive. That quick flick to the wide forehand. Left-handed, right-handed combo on each side makes it a little more convenient to share the space, alternating shots.
1-0.
Wang Zhuqi still has to play later this evening.
A few highlights from just the other day where Wang Zhuqin would hold his ground and lead way forward. Remember, in doubles, you must alternate shots every shot. No player can hit the ball twice in a row. Serves must be on the diagonal from the right side. The fighting spirit, Korea has a rich history in doubles. Been quite successful over the years. The mixed doubles, quite notably at the Olympic Games. Was the only gold medal that China did not take.
Yes.
That was at the hands of Japan.
How was that overall regarded in China, that they didn't manage a clean sweep?
It demanded an apology, a public apology through tears for Liu Shuan, and Xu Xin was there for it as well. Premature choke.
Got the edge there, Xin Yubin.
Thought she had it.
Yeah. She too is in action later on, playing Chen Meng. Wang Zhuqin playing Deng Chou. I mean, it's hard. You've got a final. You've got a reset. You've got to think about your singles later on. It's a long night for them, isn't it?
Sure is.
That's a great forehand, isn't it? Jong-un.
Yeah, powered up. Sees the spin coming in. Times it. Remember, men and women have different timing. The ball travels at different pace. Women tend to play more of a speed game, more compact. Men with longer strokes behind the table, more spin.
Again, an expansive forehand from Yun Jong-un.
You talk about the stamina being tested, and I mentioned Xu Xin just earlier. He would play three matches in a day, three finals in a day previously. And it was common for him. He was triple crown nearly back-to-back 2 weeks in a row.
Well, that's an impressive feat, isn't it?
So some players feed off of it.
Yeah.
And for Wang Zhuqin, he's quite young, 23 years old, just like Xia Xia. Nice side spin there from Im Jong-hoon. That's what the banana flick is all about.
It's worth mentioning that these two pairs have met on three occasions at the Singapore Smash last year. At the WTT star contender in Ljubljana. And at the Asian Games in October last year. Fantastic rally, the power of Wang Zhuqin.
This pattern just looks like something out of it looks like a GIF, really. Parallel, cross court, back and forth, the power from both sides. Again, the women will tend to stay a little closer to the table, but sharing the space, moving in and out, the point is to set each other up.
Well, just to complete what I was going to say, they've never beaten Sun and Wang, Yin and Xin. They've never even taken a game off them.
Well, with support like this behind them, you can understand people always enjoy watching their players succeed. They've got the fans filling the stands here, the Infinity Lounge packed with flowers and fans right to the edge.
Looking to try and counter that one. Im Jong-hoon.
It's not going to be easy. The first two shots in the rally are going to be crucial. The Korean pair looking for surprises where they can. Im Jong-hoon says it all right there. Yeah.
Tell us about the left-right combo, why that's so desirable in doubles pairings.
Well, because you have to alternate shots, you stay out of each other's way. You can also play the forehand, the more powerful shot, but again, without getting in each other's way. That's the main convenience of it.
Yeah.
the reaction time early from Won Chul-jin was awesome.
Took a lot to win this point. The Korean pair had to stay on top of everything. Heavy spin, shallow. That was the one where you heard the loud grunt from Won Chul-jin trying to get so low. A fine balance to play that ball from near the ground without getting too defensive. But if you're too ambitious about it, you don't make the shot. It's a very uncomfortable ball to play. Smart play from Im Jong-hoon.
7-9.
And the serve there, Won Chul-jin does well. Over to Shin Yubin.
Seven, ten.
And now three game points for the Chinese pairing. And the Chinese, both sides, this Infinity Arena. And you can expect a real wall of noise, as you can most evenings, but this one now, the next 3 days, it's going to be jam-packed.
Still a lot of mystery up in the air without the defending champs left in singles. Good timing here. Remember, we've got a different order of play. It switches every game. So in game one, Sun Ying Sha was receiving the serves of Shin Yubin. Now it's the other way around.
Very nicely done by Sun Ying Sha on the backhand.
Yeah, the parallel here. Take a look, spin comes in a little side and top, but ball coming in just high enough for her to get comfortable and finish the point. Sun Ying Sha, the world number one.
He's so powerful there, isn't he, Won Chul-jin?
It's incredible, inside the table, thinking about when you look at the draw that these players have, just to think how strong he is inside the table. Few have been able to shut him down.
He's hit the ball so hard, he needs to change it.
Fortunately, we do have the multi-ball system. 30 balls chosen between both of these pairs.
And new ones as well, in her. The brand that's been used here for the first time in a single smash.
Yeah, pretty cool. Neat to see some different table tennis brands rising to challenge sort of the ball dominators of the sport.
He is going to be the new number one as well, Adam, Won Chul-jin, next week. And the last time we had the one number one, it was just momentary, wasn't it? What do you see now happening? Because these are interesting times at the top of the table.
Yeah, I could see him spending a lot more time there. I think with the point loss from Fan Zhendong, the Singapore smash, he had a lot of points to defend.
And his only exit, that's a great shot as well. There's early exit, Won Chul-jin advancing.
Right. Nice shovel serve here. Short game and just inside the baseline. Won Chul-jin so good at finding that opening.
Look at that. 12 of the last 16 for Sun and Wang. That's domination.
They
are popping up with shots like that. They need more of that, the Koreans.
It's a fine balance between putting on pressure, playing aggressively, and just making it uncomfortable. Ideally, you can do all of that at once, but that's not always the case, and it's not always the answer either, depending on where the opponents are and what they're expecting.
6-3.
3-point cushion now for the Chinese pair.
A lot of twist here. Shovel serve around the outside of the ball. Variation with the side spin, sometimes top, sometimes under, sometimes straight side.
Shin Yubin there, delivering to Won Chul-jin.
A taste of his own medicine inside the table, a full stroke forehand. She has a Chinese setup. Several of the younger Korean players do, with the tackier, heavier, harder rubber on their forehand. It's all Chinese equipment.
good rally, wasn't
five,
it?
Six.
Goes long there, swinging shot.
Just to specify, at least on the forehand and the blade itself. A good chase on the move. Im Jong-hoon's got the footwork, he's got the power. Wide forehands will be tougher to cover for, well, all these players, basically, because they're trying to share the space without crossing over to become out of position. So if you can find a wide forehand a little bit out of reach, it's a good way to go here.
That's a good little period for the Koreans, which comes to an end.
Still 2 points between them, though, at the second towel break. If you're newer to table tennis, towel breaks every 6 points are allowed. Game number one, 11-7. Medium tight here, but the end of the game, this is where the champions, the defending champs back-to-back, are excellent. They really know how to take it home.
He's had to work really hard there. He's been pulled and pushed around, Im Jong-hoon.
And he didn't miss by much on this last shot. Heavy spin from both of the Korean players. The drive, that's a very unusual shot, and it almost comes down on the table. Would have been awkward to handle, especially with Shin Yubin waiting on the other side in position.
Let's be happy with that, Im Jong-hoon.
Different ways to keep your hand dry, blowing on, wiping on the table near the net. You'll see that from the players between towel breaks. Signaling to each other what their plan is, a little conversation with the hands. Every team has different signals, even players, they choose.
That was too far away, wasn't it, for Wang Chuqi?
Shin Yubin's timing on this took it so early off the bounce, not easy to do. And a timeout now on the Chinese side.
Wow.
Short stroke adds a little bit of topspin to it for that security to make sure that the ball comes down after crossing the net. He's a former Samsung player and has been coaching for quite some time now.
Oh, off the edge. A hand up from Wang Chuqi.
Well, they needed one. The Chinese pair had a comeback streak on the other side. We know the fighting spirit of the Koreans. They're taken quite seriously, but not much can be done there. Just a little nose check.
Yeah, the timing of the timeout there, what did you make of that?
Yeah, I think in general, if you think it could change the outcome of the game, that's when you call the timeout. You've got opponents coming back, you feel that the pressure could be a lot. Ultimately, your goal as coach is to make sure that your team wins. And to do that, you make sure that they're the best prepared, that they're encouraged, and that the opponents don't have momentum and confidence.
Lovely shot down the line from Sun Yingsha. That stretched Shin Yubin.
Shin Yubin's been so good on the receive. Think about how many points we've already seen where she's ripped it just early on near the table. But right now it's 2 game points for a 2-0 lead in a team that has never dropped a game against this Korean pair.
And so it continues.
Second game for Wang.
Got to win this game to stay in the match of Koreans.
When's the last time you saw Wang Chuqi go that far out of his way? In terms of balance, this is the beauty. You make your shot count, you've got time to come back, puts everything into this one, completely flies out of the way.
Ooh, oh, lovely winner, Shin Yubin.
This, for me, is the best point we've seen in this final. Tested in every shot, power right out of the gates. You can see there's no hesitation. Sasha had a long way to go to come back, and Shin Yubin still has to play it right at the baseline.
What a start we've had to this third game with these rallies.
Yeah, the quality of point right now seems very deserving of a final. Again, even the receiving side signaling their plan. They can't know for sure what's going to come, but they can still plan their intentions.
1-3.
Well, you can certainly tell from the crowd who they're backing.
It's been that way for some time. Where the Chinese players go, and here's the timeout. Kim Jong-un had a lot to say in that timeout.
He did.
This is smart.
Yeah, we keep saying it, don't we? Just how good the quality of the points of the rallies are.
Shin Yubin slows this way down. How shallow that ball was, forcing Sha Sha to play from under the table near the ground and off balance. Well planned, and Sha Sha with the tongue out. Fans are going to like that.
I wonder if that was part of the conversation and slowing it down.
Well, we heard it.
Again, they tried it there. You saw it. This time, though, Chinese on top.
First towel break, and it's not going to be easy for the Korean pair. Heavy side and top there from Wang Chuqin. And Sha Sha's done a marvelous job of constantly changing up the depth and the speed on her shots. Kim Jong-un hasn't had a good opportunity to settle into the timing.
We're already 2.5 months into 2024, but these pairs have already won titles. Shin and Yim have won the star contender Goa. Sun and Wang have won the star contender Goa, the Doha, and the WQT contender Doha as well.
3-5.
That was the most trampoline-like net I think I've ever seen. Had it hit the post, you would have maybe expected something similar, but that just completely catapulted off the net. Either way, two-point game here. The Koreans still within striking distance.
4-5.
Make that one. Really is now or never for Yim Min Shin. Great stuff there from Shin Yubin.
Staying close to the table, she's able to create such a wide angle. Watch this, moves right back in. Quick backswing, nothing much, takes it early off the bounce, takes her chances going wide, and it pays off.
Got it. 5-6.
And if memory serves, I think that's the first time that the Koreans have gone in front outside of, say, the opening point or two in a game that they must win.
And if I'm not mistaken, four in a row now from 2-5 down.
Yeah. Following that timer.
Hey.
Left, 5-6.
So it's achieving its objective for now. That run is broken.
This is tough. If you're Shin Yubin, first of all, she's played shots that have been quite challenging with a high success rate so far this match. She knows that was a good opportunity, but Wang Chuqin leaving it a little bit higher, much more shallow on the table. The problem is you play that shot, it's tough to get out of the way if you don't finish the point when it comes back.
Right. Well, they got out of that situation, didn't they, the Koreans.
Kim Jong-un from way back, not an easy ball to play. Take a look at him one more time. Jumping backhand and crossing his feet to play that backhand behind the table. Can understand the frustration. Victory on the headband for Lionheart. That's Wang Chuqin, Dato, big head they call him.
7-0.
Yeah, it's kind of a different feel at the moment, this third game. Continuing Sha on the forehand. Kim Jong-un looks a little frustrated.
That was dangerously close. Even in the replay, you wondered if it touched the side.
Yeah, I had a little
felt like
that.
It moved.
Left.
But the side doesn't count. Much
eight,
touch
seven.
Top. Even if it's
one.
Just the slightest bit. Service warning here. I was thinking about that on the last serve. Must be nearly vertical, which means no more than 30 degrees protractors out from straight up.
Bisects the two of them. Wang Chuqin
The power on his shots. Take a look one more time. Ball moves in, and this one just whizzes past. Remember, this is in response to a powerful hooking forehand.
Yeah. 2 points away. Sun and Wang.
Hit line.
Have it all to do now, Yimin Shin.
Aw. Korean pair have their supporters as well.
That's a beautiful shot from Yoon Jong-hoon.
The power behind this ball. The replay, it's still going to look like a rocket. Right to the line as well. Placement, power, precision, he's got it all, and it ties it up. Remember, the Korean pair have not yet, in their three encounters, taken a game. And they're 2 points away from doing it here, but the serves with the Chinese pair, the defending champs, who were up 2-0.
Quite the discussion there. Huge moment here for Yimin Shin. They've got game points.
Nice cover. Shin Yubin has strong wingspan. She's taller than anyone that comes to mind on the Korean team, despite the fact that she's one of the youngest and only 19 years old.
Can they convert? Yes, they can.
11,
big moment here for Yimin Shin to take.
In the mixed doubles event.
One love.
Good serve there from Sun Yuxia.
Power here as he turns the corner, the bread and butter, Wang Chuqin, with little to no hesitation. Even took a quick move. He saw that Shin Yubin was likely to go to that backhand corner. Beat her to the step around.
Adam, we quite often see a reaction slash backlash from Chinese players or pairs when they lose a game.
When you step on a dragon's tail, you can expect this sort of response. Ooh.
Tree.
Did he get something? He did.
What's that?
No, he did. He got something on that fanning shot, did he?
Yeah, caught the edge. That's a signal for edge. Scoot over. We just learned some pretty cool stuff about those glowing wristbands.
3-2.
Yeah, they'll glow during the breaks, I believe.
Apparently all ticket holders get them. That's pretty cool. Fans get them.
That's a nice thing to take back home.
3-0.
So even here once again, that's three in a row now.
Yeah, it was a good start from Sun and Wang, but Yimin Shin have bounced back superbly.
I've said this often, I'll say it again, the Chinese team does not take losing lightly.
Yeah. Even a game, right?
Right. And they know how to finish strong.
Yeah.
Oh, that was adorable. That was adorable. Oh, man. Maybe we'll get that from another camera angle later. She just cleared off his ear.
I missed that, I have to say.
She pulls a giant quarter out from behind his ear. She's like, magic! Okay, back to the match. Sha-Sha on the parallel, comfortable to step around, and it's a one-point advantage for the defending champs.
Expansive shot. He was got low down, didn't he, there? Wang Chuqin.
Yeah, we saw Shin Yubin raise her hand there. Could have caught the net on the way down, slow the ball. Either way, tied up now, 4 points apiece. If it comes down to game five, pressure will be real. Mixed doubles has a history for the Chinese team after the Olympic Games. These things do stay in the memory.
I bet they do.
Singapore, 2010.
Oh, the miracle of Moscow.
This is part of the reason that Liu Shiwen, despite being world champion in 2019, would not be trusted at the Olympic Games under certain pressures.
Xu Xin also no longer with us. In terms of playing table tennis.
Alive and well, of course, yes. Just like the ball was off the net here. Xia Xia following it up with a beautiful recovery. Not an easy ball. Sits up high enough, but it was going down the line first, yeah. And it ended up moving towards the middle of the table, which can be fairly jarring.
Listen, after a great start, it's all square still. Midway stage of this fourth game. I love that one. All of them played a part in it.
Man, and Xia Xia's finishing shot, side swiping the ball. Watch this, covers the middle. Wang Chuqin up in the air. That ball was very unusual.
She looked like she was taken out of that as well after the shot.
That was three shots in a row from the Chinese pair from Shato that were quite uncomfortable to have to deal with. The Koreans really made it uncomfortable.
At this stage, a two-point cushion is a very valuable one.
Look here, the underspin serve. Perfect read with the open face of the racket as Wang Chuqin lifts the ball to keep it out of the net and drive it down the line. When you hear the fighting or fighting, it's the Korean fans. When you hear Jayo, it's the 98% in the arena.
Seven,
that's really
six.
Nicely done by Shin Yubin. Look how far away he was.
Full extension on that forehand right to the line. Elbow as far away from the body as can be. Shin Yubin, perfection in that forehand.
Fighting away the Koreans. Oh, look at that. He's pumped his fist.
Well, this is smart play. One of the most classic tactics in doubles is to hit it right back at the player who just played the ball. That's perfect. Can't dodge it. Could have dropped under the table. That's, well, some big brain play right there from the big head himself, Dato.
Oh, 3 points now, the lead. Trying to shake it off, isn't it?
Yeah, trying to stay loose if he can in these moments.
He will pump that fist now, every point. And we now have four championship points for Sun and Wang.
Nice flick here inside the table. Shin Yubin finding the wide forehand. One step in the right direction, but a long way to go. The Korean pair against three more championship points for their opponents. Saying, hold on. We're not ready. That are trying to shoot a web. Or both.
So Sun and Wang have made it a hat-trick of Singapore smash mixed doubles titles.